Everybody, what is going on? What's happening? Going to be doing a little look at Mcfarlane Series 7 Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2003 remake. Leatherface, aka Thomas Hewitt, as played by my personal favourite Leatherface, Andrew Briniarski. And, again, like everything else in my collection, this was a figure that truly was a must have, and took such a long time to get here in terms of me actually getting around to buying him. Series 7 in the Movie Maniac line, which this does come from, featured a lot of really great characters and was the very last series in the Mcfarlane lineup, which was a shame really, because these were my favourite toy line of all time. You guys have heard me say that a lot of times. And this kind of, like most of the figures that came in the series, this was more like a diorama piece. A fully fledged sculpted figure that sat on top of a base. And this kind of depicts a scene of Leatherface in the film. There's kind of stairs leading down to his basement. So you'd kind of see this face looking down at you if he threw you down those steps into the basement where he conducts his nasties. Figure is really well sculpted, really well made. Makes you kind of really, I mean, this figure has a lot of depth to it. It really does look like you're looking through a doorframe and seeing this monster standing behind it. I absolutely love this figure. I'm actually beginning to think that this could be my favourite piece of all time. And he's only about a 7-inch fig, maybe 9 or 10 inches all in with the base. But he's so well put together, it's such a fun piece to look at for sure. The amorphous side of him. So he's all kind of hollow, he's all hollowed out. And the backing is just kind of like cardboard, but it's held. Due to its age, it's held up really well. Even just the weathering and the worn out look to the floorboards and the detail on the kind of walls. Just like the wallpaper's hanging on for dear life, you know, it's seen better days. Leatherface has got those rings on. Just the way the chainsaw pokes out from the doorframe. It's almost like a 3D. It was covering the speaker there. As I was saying, he's got the rings and stuff on. And the way that the 3D effect to this figure is just incredible, really is. It's awesome. Pretty sure you guys will agree with me that this is a pretty cool diorama setup. We'll turn him around to the back, a better view of him from the side. So this is all he really is. I'd imagine that he comes in maybe, maybe three pieces. This cardboard kind of goes into the back here, slides into the sort of ridge there. The cardboard piece gets set up there and down that panel there. And the doorway, you just kind of build again, it all clips in. When I bought this, the seller had already glued Leatherface in place. Said that he kept popping out, I think it was maybe his pegs or something, but they just wanted to make sure he was going to be a stable piece. And if they have glued him in, they've done a good job, because I like him like this. I've seen some people who pose him with his feet kind of out the doorway, but the kind of cardboard backing, not really much to look at. But you're not going to be looking at him like that anyway. Turn around, get a good view of him from the other side. But yeah, I'm blown away. I'm completely blown away by this one. I'm not really sure about the kind of greenish look to the pants there. That's about the only thing that I would say that I don't really like to it, and I wish the mask kind of had a darker skin tone. But other than that, it's a menacing piece for sure. Another great job done by Mcfarlane and the boys, and another great addition to the Doom Room. I'm Nick Addiction, guys, 1984. Take care, and we'll be back on the next one.